First of all, I'd like to know exactly how you managed to let your ex-wife throw you out of my house. Because that's the first thing people are going to ask when I tell this story.
She didn't throw me out. I left.
Oh, good. There's a twist. You see, that's what makes a good story.
Leave me alone, Charlie.
Oh, lighten up. So you tried to be friends with the woman who wrecked your life, and you failed. No damage done. Just a little personal humiliation, and at this point in your life, how would you even notice that?
Are you finished?
Did I mention I told you so?
Twice.
Counting this one? Okay, I'm finished.
Thank you.
Now, on to new business. Currently, you and I are sitting in a house that belongs to neither one of us, while your ex-wife is sitting in the house that belongs to me. You see the paradox?
I can't go back there, Charlie. She's running around with other men, having a great time, and I've got nothing.
You've got me.
Drop dead.
Okay, now you got nothing.
You know, it would be different if Judith and I were both dating.
True, but moot. Unless...
What unless?
Nah, it's stupid.
Stupider than this? Come on, what do you got?
Well, what if you were dating?
But I'm not.
But what if it looked like you were?
Oh, you mean... No way. I'm not gonna let you fix me up with one of your bimbo girlfriends.
Okay, forget it.
She'd have to be really pretty. Like a 10. And young. Like a 20.
Anything else?
And smart. And a sense of humor is important. Well-read. Good with kids. Non-smoking, of course. Oh, and easy on the piercings. Nothing south of the equator.
You're mighty picky for a guy with an adult newsstand in his sock drawer.
Homework's taken care of. He's taking a shower. You may want to check in on him in a few minutes, make sure he's not goofing around in there.
Where are you going?
I have dinner plans.
Really?
Yeah. Hard to believe, huh?
I didn't say that. I'm happy for you.
Well, thank you. And again, I'm sorry I overreacted the other night. I really do want us to have the kind of friendship that can be, you know, mutually supportive.
Me too.
You'll go out? I'll go out.
Right. So, is this someone you've been seeing for a while?
A while. But, you know, not exclusive. I don't want to get side down. Oh, that must be Camille.
She picks you up?
Well, what can I say? It's a new world, Judith. Hey, yow, wow.
You are so good for my ego. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, Camille.
Hello, I'm Judith. You're Alan's ex? Wow, I didn't expect you to be so young looking. Thank you. I mean, you have such beautiful skin for the mother of an 11-year-old. Well, thank you.
Okay, well, we should get going.
It was nice meeting you. I just hope I look half as good as her when I'm that old.
I'm betting you will.
Man, I don't know how he does it. I made a big play for her, nothing.
She's so young.
Yeah, some guys like that. I gotta hand it to you, Judith. You were very mature about the whole thing. I guess that's because you're a very mature woman.
Yeah, thanks. Jake, say goodbye to Mommy! She's going home!
Morning, everybody.
Morning. Morning. Sounds like somebody cracked open the sock drawer last night.
I'm going to ignore that because I am in such a good mood. Charlie, I don't know how to thank you.
Your ex-wife breaking the sound barrier on her way out the door was thanks enough.